myself Prakasha. I'm your instructor for the subject under organization and architecture. In this subject, we have started unit 9, that is memory organization. And in this unit, we are going to see today the topic that is auxiliary memory and the associative memory. So let me start with the first topic, that is auxiliary memory. The device that provides the backup storage are known as a auxiliary memory. The most common auxiliary memory devices used in a computer system are the magnetic disks and tape. Other component used but not as frequently as the magnetic drums, magnetic bubble memory and optical disks and so on. But mostly we are using the magnetic disk or magnetic tapes. So, to understand fully the physical mechanism of the auxiliary memory device, one must have the knowledge of the magnetics, electronics and electromechanical systems. So, we are basically going to see how it works. The average time required to reach a storage location in the memory and obtain its content is known as the access time. In electromechanical device with moving part such as a disk and tapes, the access time is consists of a strict time required to position the read and write head to the location and the transfer time required to transfer data to or from the device. So it will be consisting of these two times. Because of seek time is usually much longer than the transfer time, the auxiliary storage is organized in records or in terms of blocks. A record is a specific number of character or words. The reading or writing is always done on the entire record, or you can say entire block. The transfer read is the number of characters or the words that the device can transfer per second after it has been positioned at the beginning of its record. So, let me see what is the magnetic drums or disc. Magnetic drums and discs are the consist of the high speed rotating surface coating with the magnetic recording medium. So, the rotating surface of the drum is a cylindrical and that of the disc are the round, or you can say the flat plate. The recording surface rotates at the uniform speed and not started or stopped during the access operation. Bits are recorded as the magnetic spools on the surface as it passes a stationary mechanism known as a write head. The stored bits are detected by the change in the magnetic field produced by the recorded spots on the surface as it passes through the read head. Here, I have shown the one diagram for the magnetic disc. This magnetic disc is a circular plate constructed of the metal or the plastic and coated with the magnetized material in forms of the circles. Often both sides of the disc are used and several discs may be stashed on the one spindle with the read write head available on the each surface. Here the box shows you the read write head. All of this disc rotate together at the high speed and are not stopped or started for the access purpose. Bits are stored in the magnetized surface in spots along the concentric circles called as a track. The tracks are commonly divided into sections known as a sectors. In this most system, the minimum quantity of the information which can be transferred is the sectors. So we have divided whole disk in terms of tracks, and tracks are also divided in terms of sectors. Here the circles denotes the tracks and the smaller arcs denotes the sectors. So at a time only the content of this one particular sectors can be accessed or stored. The amount of surface available for the recording in the disk is greater than that of in a drum of the equal size. Therefore, the most information can be stored in the disk than on the drum of the comparable size. For this reason, disks have to replace the drums in a more efficient and, or you can say, in a more computers decent. The discs are the permanently attached to the unit assembly and they cannot be removed by the occasional users are known as a hard disk. This disk drive with the removable disk is known as a floppy disk. Next we will see the magnetic tapes. A magnetic tape transport consists of electrical, mechanical and the electromagnetic component to provide the part and the control mechanism for the magnetic tape unit. The tape itself is a strip of plastic coated with the magnetic recording medium, which are recorded as a magnetic spot on the tape along a several tracks. Usually 7 or 9 bits are recorded simultaneously to form a character together with the parity bit. Read or write heads are mounted on each track so that the data can be recorded and read it as a sequence of the character. So the magnetic tape unit can be stopped, started to move forward or reverse, or can be rewound. However, they cannot be restarted or stopped fast enough between the individual characters. For this reason, information is recorded in the block and it is also referred as a record. Next, we will see the associative memory. The time required to find the item stored in the memory can be reduced considerably if stored data can be identified for the access by its content or data itself rather than by the address. If you want to access some data from the memory and if you search it by means of data, then you can access it by faster way rather by accessing by its address. A memory unit accessed by its content is known as a associative memory, or you can say content addressable memory, CAM. Okay, this type of memory is accessed simultaneously and in a parallel on the basis of a data content rather than the specific address or the location. When a word is written in an associative memory, no address is given. The memory is capable of finding an empty or unused location to store the words. When a word is to be read from the associative memory, the content of that word or the part of that word is specified, and the memory locates all the words which matches with the specified contents and marks them for the reading. So by this way you can use this content accessible memory. Because of its organization, the associative memory is uniquely suited to do the parallel searches by data associations. Moreover, the searches can be done on the entire word or on a specific field within the word. An associative memory is more expensive than the random access memory because each cell must have storage capacity as well as a logic circuit for the matching its content with the external argument. Okay, and for this reason, the associative memory used in the application where the search time is very critical and must be very short. So we can see how this associative memory is organized in terms of hardware. The block diagram of the associative memory is consisting of the memory array and logic for the n words with the n bits per word. This is the block diagram for your associative memory. Here A is the argument register, K is the key register, and both are having n bits, and our memory is of size m word, and each word is consisting of the n bits. So we can say our memory is of m cross n. So here argument register is of n bit because our memory is of n bit, and key register is also of the n bit. Here we have used one extra resistor that is known as a match resistor that is consisting of m bit. Okay, small m bit, that is how many number of words you have in your memory. Okay, and each word in memory is compared in a parallel with the content of your argument register, and according to that your particular M bit in your match register is set or reset. Here we have input for this memory and read write access and the output. So let me see how we can organize this hardware. The word that matches the bit of the argument register set a corresponding bit in the match register. After the matching process, those bits in the match register that have been set indicates that there is a corresponding word have been matched. Reading is accomplished by the sequential access to the memory for those words whose corresponding bits in the match register have been set. The key register provides the mask for choosing a particular field or a key in the argument word. The entire argument is compared with each memory word if the key register contains all of the words. Otherwise, only those bits in the argument register have one in their corresponding position of the key registers are compared. Okay. Thus, the key register provides the mask for identifying the piece of information which specifies the how reference to the memory is made. So, we can see with one example. Let me see that argument register is A and the key register K has a bit configuration as shown here. This A register has some content like 101, 11111 and 00, and key register has a 3 times 1 and after all are zeros. That means it will compare only first 3 bits of each and every word with the argument register and provides the matching according to that. If we compare with word 1 that has a 100 and our argument is of 101, so it is not matched. So there will be 0 in particular match register. If we compare with word 2 that has a 3 bit as a 101 and argument register also has a 3 bit as a 101, so it is a match. So according to that the bit of match register will be 1. So here 2 number word is matching. You can also organize the hardware by this means. Here we have represented each and every bits in terms of individual. Here we have represented each and every bits by means of C, I, J. Here I represents the row and J represents the column. And M1, M2, M3, M4 up to Mn represents your match register. A represents your argument register and K represents your key register. Its particular bits can be represented by its prefix bit. Cell Cij is the cell for the bit J in the word I. A bit in Ai is the argument register is compared with all of the bits in the column J of that array, provides the key Ki is a 1. This is done for all columns J equals to 1, 2 up to N. If a match occurs between all of the unmasked bits of the argument and its bits in the word I, the corresponding bit in Mi is that match register is set to 1. If one or more unmasked bit of the argument and the words do not match with the Mi, then it is clear to 0. By this way, we can represent your hardware. So we are ending our today's session over here. If you have any query, then you can contact me.